Aiming a crossbow at someone else. Why are guys having so much trouble here? Oh, that's right, the allies have a shitload of crap troops in them. On them. Oh, this is bad. I'm gonna get shot to shoot from the side. I think they're doing, if I remember correctly, the Prophecy of Pandor 4 was supposed to be like a couple of hundred years after, you know, the, like, Pandor 3. So some empires should be still the same, I think. Oh yeah, the religion stuff is kind of not really fleshed out that much. But it's still playable. I mean, it's enjoyable, but it's so fucking slow. It's annoying. And you like basically need companions to have a lot of troops. I don't know why they did that. Like made it so your companions contribute to the amount of troops you can have. But I guess, I mean, you know, the companions and you are heroes and whatnot, great warriors, so you can attract more shit. So it kind of makes sense, but I still like the old method better. Well, when it just counts in renown and your honor, and your charisma and leadership. Yeah, it takes a long ass time to fucking make money. Basically what you need to do is just go around the map, you know, from like, I don't know how it's said, to the like up to Norway and Denmark, just trade shit, then go right back and trade more. So boring in the beginning. But the sieges are nice though. I like the fact that you can build sanitation and what else? Starve them out and build a blockade and whatnot. I like that feature. And thankfully it doesn't take like 1,000 days to siege out a city. It takes only, what, 7 to siege out a fort, I think. And again, because, you know, every kingdom is, you know, has shit close by, you really need to kill them first or take them prisoner. So they don't just run into you when you start besieging. Oh, and the fucking penalty if you have more troops than you're able to support. Oh my fucking god. Basically, I just... And all the features like blood loss and weapons breaking, I turned half of that shit off, really. I'm not really into the realism. I'd rather just have fun in the game. Will I be able to stab this guy? Probably not. Okay, I can move in here. There is a Twitch pick vote or poll in the channel description, so you can choose which faction will I focus on in Atheas. So far I think we got 2 votes in the Nordic Union, and I guess that's good. I won't have cavalry to run down the enemies. Well, if crazy, if you go to their website now, basically the game is finished. It has all the basic or everything Warband has, but they're just adding more fleshed out systems. Like, I think the last one they did, it was if you're taken prisoner, if you do actual crime, some loot something, the faction you loot or raid is gonna have a price on your head, or, you know, are gonna keep tabs on you. And if you get caught, you actually get put in a prison. You just don't, you're not like in a party and move with them as they move. So at least they change that, because, you know, it doesn't make sense. You escape and whatnot. And they made, you know, You can have a kid and have him grow up and take over when you die, so you basically can age. That's a nice feature. The game is finished, they're just adding the new shit in. And there's always gonna be people who like Warband a bit, you know, better than the new game. There's always gonna be some of us who like the older shit better. But so far, from what I've seen, it's decent. I think there was a post on Steam too, which they show a battle, and the infantry line actually, you know, formed a shield wall, and the first row had their shields in front, and the second row had their shields on top, so they can't get shot by archers. So that's really interesting if they do that on their own, so you don't need to, you know, tell them to, or maybe it's a formation thing, probably. So that's nice too. Let's see, what else can we take for the garrison? But they, like I said, they're finished with the game, they're just, you know, fleshing it out. Since they didn't have time to flesh out Warband, they were still on the Paradox. And now I think they're, you know, they're publishing it themselves. Let's leave these. I think we still have enough. Maybe we can take Amandor still. Let's see. And I think once we take Amandor, I'm gonna disband and I'm not gonna be, well, not disband, but I'm not gonna be a marshal anymore. It's too much work. And we get nothing. Okay, now, well, this guy is staying here, good. Yeah, I'm gonna leave the Arvixon for Fearsvane, hopefully they take it. They'll throw with the Char. Then again, they might actually, you know, declare war on us, not Fearsvane, not Ramestern. We're holding most of their shit. I think I saw Knudar Castle being besieged at some point in the events. Not sure though. A Weyburg. Oh, fucking course. I should have seen it, Crazy and everyone else. Like, I was at Windholm besieging it, and I was just about to, you know, start the battle and take it, and then the fucking Empire pieced them out. And that's the last city they have. Oh. I so wish if you're a marshal you can actually declare war and ask for peace and whatnot. So then get screwed over like that. So I guess let's just tell these guys to, you know, go do whatever. And I guess we'll go and deal with the three seers, if they're still here. And all of those lords, we had like 20 of them, are now free. Should have sold them off as soon as I got them. Now where the fuck are the three seers? Should be here. Okay, three seers patrol. So they are near Amandor. Or should be anyway. Okay, nope. Oh yeah, chase one guy, don't go fucking retake Quintal. Why would you do that? And there they are, 1,000 units on them. Move the archers up. Okay, these guys, they still didn't get their shield, well, armor pieces. It was only 11 days, so they should get them in a bit. I need some heavy cavalry. Okay, now let's go beat their ass. They actually think they can take me on. The only reason I regret not putting this on a quit without saving is because probably one of these days I'm gonna click on yes, there is no need for battle. Let us sit together and get fucked. Lose everything. And I didn't change more. Well, I don't really need lances for this. Or spears. Oh, never mind. Why did I think I could actually outrange that guy? Yeah, we need a spear. Everyone is in position. We did get lance though, so that's... Yeah, I'm gonna go back for the spear. I think if you leave the formations on in this... Like the formations are in... Viking Conquest, you can actually use a shield wall like in Viking Conquest. Just use them as a tank and move up to the enemy and just kill everything that comes near. Since that's the best tactic in Viking Conquest, you don't want to charge in at all in that game, unless it's like versus bandits or something. Even then, like even versus bandits, you want to have a shield wall in front of you and just move them like a turtle. Now that was an epic miss. This is a seer, right? Yeah. Okay, that guy almost got me. Okay, now this is gonna be piss easy to kill, so let's just restart and, you know, destroy them. And we got the perfect hill behind us for this. Let's go a little bit closer. Actually tell the cavalry to, you know, stall them a bit. I want to move in as close as possible. Okay, they should be fine. And they got lances. Ah, shit. Can't try and kill any of them. Why do we have urban lancers here? I so wish the actual troops that you get on the field are correspond to the like where you put them in the party screen, so you don't get your best troops on the field. Ooh, we're even. Now this is how it's done. A shitload of infantry. Maybe I should have had the formations on, so I can actually move them as a turtle, or in what was it called, tortoise formation. I told you to. Oh no, that's archers. Shit. Basically just move them 10 feet by 10 feet, or paces, 10 paces by 10 paces. Okay, now we're getting the deserters in, that this is gonna be piss easy to kill off. See, can we break the kill feed again? We should be able to. Especially if I fucked over with the damage numbers. No, I wish I had more infantry on the field.
Between black kisses, I warded to you. Hear not my words. unveiling the truth. Love is forever, but just for a few.
No kill faith breaking for us. Yeah. Maybe? No? Okay, we did break the kill phase, it disappeared completely. I think our archers are gonna be able to beat these without a problem. Yeah, these are only deserters. Imagine if Mountain Blade actually had population stats. So you can't really out-recruit your population growth. Or can't recruit, or you have a limit on on how many troops you can recruit. I kind of might want my kill feed back, so I can see if I'm losing archers or not. Oh come on, why did you block? Why didn't you kill him, Adonia? Okay, good. We only lost 5. Any archers? Nope. Okay, we're good. But we didn't get the quality gem. I guess we could pick up the Darkwood bow, but why would we? Okay, we dealt with that. There's a Misty Mountain army and 3 Jatu. I'm not gonna face the Jatu, I really don't care for them. Okay, I think I'm gonna end it here. It was 3 hours, almost 3 hours and a half. Well, let's see, maybe we can. Yeah, we have enough to start upgrading our Knighthood Order guys with the helmet, so we can finish them off with that. And we can do an older tournament too. So let's go do that. And we need more money. I am gonna lower the difficulty. No. The Noldor are quick enough, I don't need them to be faster. And I still might lose. I think I want to kill this guy first so I don't get shot in the ass. Okay, good. Ooh, that was close. They're all aiming for me. I would probably got an instant kill if all of them shot me. Oh yeah, line up, don't even pay attention to me. Oh, that's so nice. Okay, so I didn't actually do what I was wanting to do. We didn't get killed in the shore. Since the, you know, AI decided they want peace even though we were at their doorstep of the last city, or Fife. And now when I started rolling on Raven's turn, they decided to peace out. I so wish there was a, you know, like if you're a... if you're the marshal to like... tell the king not to peace out yet, so we can finish them off. Because that's basically the only reason I became a marshal. So I can maybe avoid that. Now we got the noble dark horse. Not much money though. Nah, I'm gonna sell it. They don't need to keep. They don't actually have the money to pay me.
That's surprising.
Okay, let's see, and how many days does it do we need to start upgrading the Knight with all the lances? Further. Roman Empire and... yeah, Firdwain. Looks like the game is pushing us to kill him first. And even our morale is going to shit. How many days do we need? No, not that. Wait, what? Yeah, we will do that. Lancers. 3 more days. Okay, so... I'm gonna end this stream here. Then we're gonna... in the next one, upgrade them fully, and then, you know, continue. Conquer. I guess we're gonna be at war with Fizzme by that point. But at least we have the Lancers, and we're only gonna need 150 more to finish up the infantry, the urban cohorts. And after that, the only thing we need to do really is, you know, conquer the whole map. But anyway, guys, we're gonna raid Drid. He's a good guy. He's an American. He streams Wiki 2 a lot. I think he's streaming Wiki 2 right now, I think. Anyway, guys, thank you for watching. Have a good morning, good day, good night, and see you next time.